Dear students, welcome you all to APG Pathsala. I am Dr. S. Gandhimadi, Associate Professor, Department of Economics, Avinash Lingam Institute for Home Science and Higher Education for Women, Coimbatore. In this module, we are going to discuss about method of collection of secondary data. Introduction: the data which have been collected and processed by some agency or person or used by other agency or person for a statistical purpose is called secondary data. For example, population data collected and published by Registrar General of India in the form of census will be secondary data for any agency or person who utilizes it for their statistical purpose. According to M.M. Ryer, secondary data are those already in existence and which have been collected for some other purpose than answering of the question at hand. Objectives. The first objective is to study the difference between primary and secondary data. The second objective is to discuss various sources of secondary data. And then third one is to study the advantages and disadvantages of secondary data. Let us discuss difference between primary and secondary data. The first difference is primary data are original and like raw materials for statistical inquiry, whereas secondary data are like finished constructed goods because they have been processed and analyzed earlier also. The second difference is primary data are collected by some agency or person by using the method of data collection, whereas secondary data are already collected and processed by some person or agency and is ready for use. The next difference is the collection of primary data requires a considerable amount of money, time and personnel's as whole plan of investigation is initiated, whereas secondary data are less time consuming and cheaper as they are taken from published and unpublished materials. The next difference is primary data fulfill the requirements of statistical investigations objectives, whereas secondary data are not always according to the objectives of the users. That is, the reason that they are used after a deep scrutiny, filtration and alterations. In other words, it has to be critically examined. In fact, the difference between primary and secondary data is only quantity, that is a matter of degree or relativity, not that of nature. The same set of data may be secondary in the hands of one and primary in the hands of others. In general, the data are primary to the sources who collects and process them for the first time and are secondary for all other sources who later use such data. Let us discuss what are the methods of collection of secondary data. The secondary data can either be collected from published materials like census, survey reports, abstracts, etc., or from unpublished materials like dissertations, official records, memorandums, etc. Let us discuss what are all the sources of published statistics. There are many organizations such as government, non-government, autonomous, etc., which includes both at national and international level, which collect and publish statistics in journals, periodicals, abstracts, directives, etc., relating to business, trade, finance, labor markets, exchange positions, share prices, health, population, etc. regularly. It is the source of knowledge which serves as a powerful aid to investigators, researchers interested in analyzing and interpreting the scenario both at national and international levels. The chief sources of published statistics are, first one is central government publications. The first one is various ministries and departments of central government publish regularly statistics on a number of subjects of current interest, that is prices, wages, production, etc. Some of worth mentioning publications of different ministries like commerce, defense, labor, planning, agriculture and irrigation are monthly abstract of statistics, monthly statistics of production of selected industries in India, agricultural statistics of India, annual survey of industries, abstract of agricultural statistics, Indian trade journals, Indian labor statistics, etc. Then let us discuss reports of committees and commissions. Government of India and state governments generally appoint certain commissions related to some special field. The findings of these commissions are published in the form of reports which contain valuable statistical information. For example, the reports of national labor commissions, reports of various wage committees for different industries, reports of Mandal Commission on Backward Classes, National Agricultural Commissions, etc. are the storehouse of data. Census data for India and state, vital statistics of India, population bulletin, etc. are few important publications in the field of population of data published by the Government of India. Besides these, a number of departments in the state and central governments like income tax departments, Directorate of Food and Civil Supplies, railways, post offices, excise departments, etc. also publish statistical reports on current problems, and information supplied by them is in general more authentic and reliable than obtained from other sources on the same subject. Then let us discuss what are the semi-government publications. Like central government, semi-government statistical organizations like RBI, the Institute of Economic Growth, Directorate of Economics and Statistics of States, etc. also publish statistics in their publications like RBI Bulletin, Currency and Finance, Bank of India Bulletin, etc. Likewise, municipal and district board, corporations, block and panchayat samitis, etc. also publish statistics related to births, deaths, health, sanitation, etc. which are fairly reliable and authentic. Then next, university and research institute publication. There are several universities, departments and institutes which are actively engaged in researches. The findings of these researchers are regularly published in magazines, journals and periodicals. They are quite reliable and authentic as they are collected, processed and analyzed by the specialists in the field. Some of these institutes are Indian Statistical Institute, Calcutta and New Delhi, National Council of Applied Economics and Research, New Delhi, Indian Council of Agricultural Research, New Delhi, Indian Agricultural Statistics Research Institute, IASRI, New Delhi, National Council of Educational Research and Training, New Delhi, Indian Space Research, Bangalore, etc. Let us discuss publications of commercial and financial institutions. A number of private, commercial and trade associations collect and publish statistics related to trade and commerce. In India, Indian Cotton Mills Federation, Jute Mills Association, Sugar Mills Associations, Paper Manufacturers Association, Federation of Indian Chambers of Commerce, Institutes of Chartered Accountants of India, trade unions, stock exchanges, banks, etc. also collect and publish statistics. In the last few years, there has been enormous growth in the statistical literature issued by private agencies in the country. Let us discuss the sources of secondary data from periodicals, journals, and newspapers. Statistics related to various field of knowledge can be from periodicals, journals, and newspapers like Economic Times, Financial Express, Commerce, Eastern Economist, Productivity, Manpower Journal, Yearbooks, and many others. The daily, weekly, and monthly situations of prices, shares, productions, money supply, foreign exchange situations, and many other related subjects can well be studied through the statistics published in these journals. Then, let us discuss the international organizations' publications. The publications of United Nations organizations, UNO, like Statistical Yearbooks, Demographic Yearbook, International Labour Yearbook, World Bank Report, IMP publications, LLO's publications, ESCAP, and IFC publications are few indispensable statistical sources on international basis. Perhaps the statistics published in this volume are most exhaustive and highly reliable. Besides these, there are many other international bodies which are actively engaged in publishing statistics on variety of subjects. Now let us discuss other sources of secondary data. Many other sources like market reviews and reports, All India Radio, etc. are also important source of secondary data. And then let us discuss unpublished sources of secondary data. Statistical data can also be obtained from unpublished materials like doctoral dissertations of different universities and research institutes, personal records of business houses and government offices, personal researches of individuals and voluntary organizations, etc. Then let us discuss what are all the e-sources of secondary data. The first one is the publication of Reserve Bank of India that can be obtained from www.rbi.org.in. Then second website is https://www.indiastat.com. It is the publication of Central Statistical Organization. We can obtain many data from this website. And then third one is the publication of MHRD. That website is mhrd.gov.in/stat. Then next, yet another government publication is available in the website https://data.gov.in/. And yet another publication of government is www.mospi.gov.in/graph1. And then yet another Government of India publication is available in the website https://india.gov.in/data-portal-india. Then yet another secondary data available, yet another source of secondary data is www.secondarydata.com/secdata/intl.asp. And then Planning Commission has also website for data, that is nic.in/data/data-table. And then World Bank has a secondary data source, that is www.worldbank.org/. Then yet another website available for secondary data is https://rbi.org.in/acripts/publication-report-details.aspx?id=796. So these are all the various websites available for collecting the secondary data. What are the precautions in the use of secondary data? Statistical data obtained from secondary sources of information, though are in many ways advantages, but should not be used without any scrutiny of their reliability, accuracy, suitability, and adequacy. It is essential to use these data in critical manner, as they may be unsuitable to the subject of inquiry. Proper care should be taken to edit it so that it is free from inconsistencies, errors, and omission. The researcher using secondary source of data for the work must satisfy himself with regard to the following facts. The first one is reliability of the data. The reliability of secondary data can be judged by the integrity and experience of the agency source of information and method of data collection used. Then second one is suitability for the purpose. The data suitable for one purpose may not be suitable for other. Hence, one should find out the suitability of the data by investigating the nature, scope, objectives, units and terms, homogeneity and time of collection, etc. of the secondary data. The next one is adequacy. It is necessary to use adequate data to avoid biases. Hence, researcher should use secondary data with great care and caution. The following are the advantages of secondary data. Let us discuss what are the advantages of secondary data. First one, it saves time. In the internet era, the secondary data are available in various websites. It saves time. For example, the time series data on Indian economy in the Handbook of Statistics on Indian Economy, published by the Reserve Bank of India, Bombay. Similarly, in the website of Reserve Bank of India, the other secondary sources such as the Handbook of Statistics on states in which state-wise data are available. The economic survey is available in the website. The census report is also available in the website. Hence, it saves time and the researcher need not travel and approaches the respondents as in the primary data collection. Then, easy accessibility is yet another advantage of secondary data. The accessibility of secondary data is very easy. Just simple click of websites, we can access the data. The third one is the secondary data saves money. The collection of primary data is very expensive, but the collection of secondary data saves money. Continuous or regular surveys such as government's census or official registers are especially good for such research purpose. The fact of being performed on a regular or continuous basis allow researchers to evaluate. The next one, reanalyzing data can also lead to unexpected new discoveries. For example, the World Values Survey Association usually publish the so-called World Values Survey books. They are a collection of publications based on data from the World Value Surveys. Since the database used may be accessible for outsiders, you can analyze the data and come up with new relevant conclusions or simply verify and confirm previous results. Disadvantage. Let us discuss what are all the disadvantages of secondary data. Then first one is inappropriateness of the data. Data collected by oneself is collected with a concrete idea in mind. Usually, to answer a research question or just meet certain objectives. In this sense, secondary sources may provide you with vast amount of information, but quantity is not a matter. This is simply because it has been collected to answer different research questions or objectives. The inappropriateness may be, for instance, because of the data was collected many years ago, the information refers to an entire country. When one aims to study a specific region, or the opposite one aims to study an entire country, but the information is given in a region by. There are two possible ways to be taken when standard deviation is not appropriate. To answer your research question partially with a subsequent lack of validity. Then second one, you need to find an alternative technique of data collection such as survey or interviews. Then second important drawback of secondary data is lack of control over data. That is, government and other official institutions are often a guarantee of quality data, but it is not always the case. The quality of available secondary data depends on the sources of data. If the sources of data are reliable sources, the research outcome may be good. If the data are from unreliable source, the research outcome may not be strong. Then third one is non-availability of adequate data. For example, we may be in need of data on gross domestic product from the year 1950 to 2017, but the data may be availed only from the year 1980 to 2015. It reveals inadequacy of data. Then fourth one, the required data may not be availed in required classification. The data may be availed in one classification and the required classification may be different. Then yet another disadvantage is, if the secondary data is not availed for one particular period of time, the process of research may be withheld. And then yet another disadvantage of secondary data is, sometimes the objectives of the study may not be based on the research problem and research gap, but it may be based on the availability of secondary data. Let us summarize. A proper care and caution in use of secondary data based on above points may help the researcher to have a valid and reliable data. The purpose of the investigation that led to the collection of data in the first place and the definition of the terms employed should be known in order to ensure the applicability to the problem in hand. In addition, the nature and reputation of the collecting agency should be considered. Needless to say, the investigator must have sufficient confidence in the integrity of his source to use their data without fear of undue bias or misrepresentation.